After this theory session, I am going to demonstrate about the how the secure socket layer works in the real world. So for that, we are going to start with the Wireshark here. Right now, I am going to open the Wireshark through my terminal. See, Wireshark, as you have seen just in the yesterday session, that Wireshark is a tool which is used to capture the packets at the interfaces. So here we are going to capture the packets at this interface Ethernet 4. As you can see that, so this is the interface in my virtual machine through which I am going to contact to the web server. Now I am going to google.com. Notice one important thing here, I just typed google.com. I have not written anything else, not HTTP, not HTTPS. Yes, still, as you can see that it automatically comes with HTTPS. And in the URL, you can also notice SSL in the end. So our server and a browser know that this particular session has to be secure. So if we want to know that, we have to inspect the packets which were communicated between these two entities. For that, we are going to see the packet captured in this process. So it is started with the standard query to google.com as a DNS, and now we get the response in the second message, which is query response for with the IP address of google.com, and now is starting with three-way handshake TCP. This is the first message, which is SYN, followed by SYNACK and then ACK. So now TCP handshake has been completed. Now the first message, which is a GET request, HTTP request. If we want to know the content of this request, we can see here. The host is google.com, of course. This is the content of the HTTP request which is sent to the server. And now we will wait for the reply, HTTP reply, which is here. Here we can see that it is 302, means moved temporary, means this particular URL has been moved temporary to this new location. So Google responded with that the URL you are trying to browse is now has been moved to this particular location. So our browser will do, it will close this particular TCP session and start a new one. So you can see the FIN and FINACK here, and now again the same procedure will happen with DNS again, then DNS response, again SYN, SYNACK, ACK, and notice this GET, it is now to the new location. And now we will wait for the HTTP response, which is again 302, which is saying that it is again moved temporary. So what's Google trying to do? He's trying to do this. Now you can see that it is HTTPS. So through this procedure, Google server told the browser that you have to create a secure session to talk to me. This is HTTPS. Ending with SSL. So now again the session will be closed. We get the FIN ACK. And the new session start. SYN, SYNACK, ACK. And now just after the three-way handshake, as the browser know that I have to create a HTTPS session, so it is started with SSL protocol. As professor already told you that SSL protocol contains of two protocols. First one is handshake protocol and the second one is recorded protocol. So for the handshake protocol there are four steps. The first step is client hello message. This is the initiating message which is sent from the browser to the server. So this client hello message, what it contains is, we can see here, this is the IP layer and then TCP and then secure socket. By the way, secure socket layer works above TCP and below application layer, so it is sandwiched between them. So now we are going to see the content. See, this is handshake protocol, client hello within that. So how a server will know that this particular message is a handshake message? So to answer that, we have a content type. See, if you try to see at the hexadecimal value, it is written as 16. In decimal it means 22. So when a server see 22 in here, it knows that it is a handshake protocol. And within handshake protocol, as you can see here, it is handshake protocol, and within that it is client hello. And notice here, client hello has content type as 01, same as in hexadecimal value. You can see the 01 here down there. In the bottom you can also see the type of handshake message, SSL dot handshake dot type, which is of 1 byte, of course. So this is the content, basic content of client hello message. Now the important content of the client hello message. Now we come to the important message, which is session ID. So as professor had told you, when the client hello message come, it can contain a session ID which is used to resume a previous session, or the browser can initiate a new session. So if he wants to resume a session, he will send that particular session's ID in the client hello message. If he want to create a new session, it will respond with just session ID length is equal to 0. So here the client wants to create a new session, that's why he responded with the client as 0. And here we can see the random nouns. This is random nouns. As you can see that in the bottom, it is random challenge used to authenticate the server, SSL dot handshake dot random byte. This is of 28 byte. This is 28 byte data nouns, and this is our array. And the third most important thing is cipher suite. So basically cipher suite is a negotiation business, means the browser tells the server that, okay, I have these 23 set of algorithms, which do you want to use? So it simply shows all the 23 suites. See, this is the list of all the cipher suites it supports. So what a cipher suite is, here you can see that it is a bunch of algorithms which are used for key exchange, for signature generation and its verification, for encryption purpose, and for calculating MAC and digest. So as you can see here, in this particular highlighted cipher suite, we have ECDHE, which is elliptic curve Diffie-Hellman exchange, which is used for the key exchange mechanism. The second one is RSA, which is going to be used for signature and verification. The third one is AES-128, so which is used for the encryption purpose, which is 128 bits. GCM is the mode of operation, and SHA-256 is a digestion protocol. So now we are receiving server hello. So when the server received this message, this client hello message, it respond with that, okay, out of all these cipher suite I want to go with this. So as you can see that again the content type is 22, which is handshake, and within handshake we have server hello, which is 2, and this is the random nouns given by the server. So it is our RB, which is of course 28 byte, and you can see the cipher suite here. This particular cipher suite with code C02B is going to be used. Okay, notice one thing here, it is session ID length is equal to 0. So the server may return a empty session ID to indicate that the session will not be cached and therefore cannot be resumed. So if the server wants to resume a session, he will respond with a session ID. So we have done with the client hello message, the server hello message, and now comes the important thing, which is the certificate of the server. In the certificate there are several fields, but some of them are very, very important to note, like the public key of the subject, which is google.com here, the signature, the certificate authority, the validity of the certificate. So the certificate can be seen here in the Wireshark also, and the better way, I mean the graphical way to view the certificate is this. It can be viewed in the in your own browser. See, you can do this at your own end in the lab session, that here you can see the HTTPS, and you can also must be seeing a lock. What this lock is, if you click on it, it will show you, you are connected to google.co.in, this is run by of course Google but verified by Google in, and the connection to this website is secure. And if you want to know what the certificate is in this particular case, go to the more information, view certificate, see. So now we have the certificate of google.com. So issued to google.com, its serial number, issued by of course Google Internet Authority G2, which is the CA in this case. And now here you can see that validity, validity is Wednesday 2nd of July, I mean just 10 days before, and it expires on 30th of September 2014. So within that period google.com can use that server, that certificate, and these are the fingerprints SHA-1 and MD5. So this is a basic detail of the certificate. And now if you want to go the detailed information of what a certificate contains, then go to the detail tab. See, this is the certificate hierarchy. In this hierarchy there are certain certificate fields and their fields value. So as I have already told that there are several fields, and not all of them but some are very important. So I am going to show you like this. So certificate signature algorithm, which is SHA-1 with RSA encryption. So for signature purpose this particular encryption has been used. And now I am going to show the validity, which is 2nd of July and not after 30th of September. So this is the validity purpose. And now the most important thing, subject public key information. So as professor already told, it uses elliptic curve cryptography as a public key cryptography using NIST P256, which is a standard you will come to know in the later in this workshop. Now subject public key, which is of 256 bits with a base point of length 256 bits. Again certificate signature algorithm, certificate signature value, which is 256 bytes. So after signing the signature becomes of size 256 bytes. So these are the information a certificate contains. So now certificate business has been over. So we have through step 1 and step 2. Now comes the step 3, which is now the client generates the pre-master secret, send it over, and both client and the server will compute the 6 keys, the 6 secrets. So after the client computes its secret, it sends client key exchange with chain cipher spec. So we are going to inspect what it contains. Again, it is a handshake, so with the content type is 22, and within handshake it is client key exchange, so content so type is 16. And after client key exchange, you can see that it is chain cipher spec protocol. So what does it mean? It means that after this message, the client is gonna send all the message which will be encrypted. One thing to notice here, it's from the client side, not from the server side. See, so this is 10.0.2.15 is my ID, which is my browser ID, I mean laptop ID, and the 74.125.236.56 is google.com ID. So it is the message from the client to the server that client key has been exchanged and changed the cipher suit. Now we will wait for the server's response for the chain cipher suit. This is application data from the client. This is the encrypted handshake message from the server to the client that okay, from now on even I will send the data in the encrypted format. See, this is here, this message is from the server to the client. So after this the handshake has been finished, and now the record layer protocol will work, which will encrypt the data using the session keys just negotiated. Okay.